Good morning, students. My name is Veeraya, working as assistant professor in EC department. In this semester, I am going to handle the subject electronic switching systems for final year BTech students, first semester. So before starting the syllabus, first of all, I would like to say that this subject is entirely deal with telecommunication networks. Okay, this subject is entirely deal with telecommunication networks. So what is the meaning of telecommunication? Tele means long distance voice communication, okay, and network means with the help of multiple devices we can communicate each other to perform some task. Okay, we know we use telephones for making calls to our friends as well as browse the internet for sending emails and for shopping. But we don't know exactly what is happening inside, right? That is my question. The important question to be noted here is, we don't know what is happening inside. So this subject deals with the process of sending voice as well as data through the network. Okay, that is called your telecommunication networks. Always discuss this definition. Telephone means what? Long distance voice transmission. A network is called communication between multiple devices. Now we'll see how the telecommunication is evolved. The first one is transmission of telegraph signals over wires is the development in the field of telecommunications. So it was introduced in the year 1837 in Great Britain and in 1845 in France. So to transmit these telegraph signals, it uses a telegraph. Here the signals are transmitted with the help of Morse codes. Okay, now we'll see an example for Morse code. For each and every alphabets or numbers, we have a Morse code. Now we'll see an example of how to transmit a hello world signal through this telegraph. Okay.
Example.
So here, by pressing that button with the time gaps, it is going to decode the alphabets or numbers. Example. If you observe here, for all the alphabets, we have some codes. A, for A, if you observe the time gaps. So if I press that time gaps, it is going to take it as A. So for transmitting these Morse codes, we require two skilled persons. One for sending these Morse codes at sending end, another at the receiving end to understand what he is sending. So for this type of communication, two skilled persons are required. That means a normal common person cannot able to send or understand the signals. Okay, this is the drawback in telegraphs. The next one is Alexander Graham Bell demonstrated his telephone set in the year 1876 for telephone communication. He used the concept of point-to-point connection. What is the meaning of point-to-point connection means? I have two subscribers. Okay. If I want to make an arrangement between these two, I have to lay some wires between the two subscribers. Here I have to note down the terminology. Here the first terminology I am using is subscriber. Who is a subscriber? For example, I am using Airtel. I am using Airtel network. Therefore, I am called as a Airtel subscriber. That means the persons who are connected to the network are called as subscribers. This is the first technical word we are using in this subject, subscriber, right? Okay. Here, a dedicated wire path is present between the two subscribers. It is called as point-to-point connection. Okay. So, there are examples of evolution of your telephone sets. So, from Graham Bell to the latest mobile phones. Okay. If you observe clearly here, up to 1920, there is no dialing mechanism. Nowadays, what we'll do? If I want to communicate with some person, I have to dial some number, right? So, there is no dialing system up to 1920. That means up to 1920, we use manual switching systems. Okay. Later, they developed the technology for dialing a number. Okay. For example, I want to call some person. So, I have to dial a specific number. Right? This numbering system is not available in those days. But nowadays, we have a specific numbering system for each and every subscriber. This is one example of point-to-point connection demonstrated by Graham Bell. Here, to establish connection between the calling and call subscriber, now we are coming across one more terminology. This is called as calling subscriber. And he is called as called subscriber. Okay. To establish a connection between calling and call subscriber, we use a dedicated wire pairs. One is for transmitting the signal, another for receiving the signal. So this is an example for point-to-point connection. Okay. Now I am taking more number of subscribers. Now see here. So from each subscriber, we are connecting to the all the subscribers with the help of dedicated wire pairs. I will come across one more technology that is called as link. This is called as link. What is link? A link is nothing but a dedicated wire pair that is connecting two subscribers is called as link. Okay. So this type of network is called as connected network. It is called as fully connected network. What is the meaning of fully connected network? There is a path between every subscriber. If you take it as A, this is B, this is C, D and E. Okay, there is a specific path for each and every subscriber. That is called as fully connected network. What is the advantage of this network and what is the drawback of this network? If you observe clearly, the advantage is it is a non-blocking network. And one more technology come here. Non-blocking. What is the meaning of non-blocking network? Non-blocking. Until unless he is busy, okay, you can easily make a call to him. Okay, for example, A want to make a call to B. If he is free, that means he is not talking with any other, then I can easily establish a connection between A and B. Okay, that is called as non-blocking network. Okay, this is the one advantage of a fully connected network. What is the drawback? The drawback is, as the number of subscribers increases, the number of links increases. If you observe clearly here, to establish one connection, one link is required between two subscribers, right? One link is required between two subscribers. Therefore, how many links are possible here? If I am having n subscriber, the total number of links is equal to nc2. Okay. What's the formula of NC2? N factorial by N minus 2 factorial into 2 factorial. This is the formula of NC2, right? Expand it. N into N minus 1 into N minus 2 factorial by N minus 2 factorial into 2 factorial. What will get? This will get cancelled. The answer is N into N minus 1 by 2. Right? So, these many links are required to establish a fully connected network. So, what is the drawback if this many number of links are present? Now, here we can see a factor called as utilization factor. So, based upon the utilization factor, we will say that whether the design is good or bad. So, this is the formula of utilization factor, number of links occupied by total number of links. If you see here, for n subscribers, if I am assuming all are in engaged, in that case, the total maximum possible calls are n by 2, right? Because 2 subscribers can make a call. Okay, what are the number of links here? We derived it, right? N into n minus 1 by 2, that is equal to 1 by n minus 1. As the number of subscribers increases, what happens? This U factor get reduced, approximately equal to 0 if n is a very large number. Okay. So the drawback in this point-to-point communication is it is having very low utilization. That means all the links are not utilized properly for a given duration of say 1 hour or 1 day. For duration of 1 hour, the utilization factor is approximately equal to 0. That means the resources are not utilized properly. As a good engineer, our objective is to utilize the resources, right? So for that, what can you do? So our objective is to improve the utilization factor. So for that, we have to reduce the number of links, because if you see the formula of U is equal to N by 2 by N into N minus 1 by 2. What is this? This is called total number of links. So our objective is to if I am decreasing the denominator, I can increase utilization factor. Okay. So for this, I am using a device along with the subscribers to reduce the number of links. Right. So this is the system. This is called as switching matrix or switching exchange or telephone exchange. Now see here, total n subscribers are there here. How many links are there here? Only n links are there, right? With the help of n links and a device switching matrix, I can able to communicate n number of subscribers with n links only, right? For example, I want to establish a connection between S2 and SN minus 1. What can I do? With the help of this switching element, we call this as switching element, I can able to establish a connection between S2 and SN minus 1. See here. With the help of an internal connection, I can able to establish a connection between S2 to SN minus 1. In this case, what is here? U is equal to n by 2 are the number of maximum calls by total number of links is n only. Therefore, U is increased. So, therefore, this is a good connection. Okay. But the drawback in this method is since it is not a fully covered network, blocking may occur. This is another terminology, blocking. What is the meaning of blocking network? Because of lack of switching paths, a subscriber may not be able to connect to the another subscriber. That is called as blocking. Therefore, this network comes under a blocking network. Whereas a fully connected network is example for non-blocking network, right? So this is also called as a telephone exchange. What we know nowadays, we'll call them as telephone exchanges, right? Now, this is called a switching exchange or a telephone exchange or a switching matrix. Now, we can design this particular switching system in different ways. This is the classification of switching systems. Two types, manual and automatic. What is the meaning of manual switching system is, with the help of human intervention, we are going to establish a connection between calling and called subscriber. That is called as manual switching systems. It is having its own drawbacks. We'll come across in within 5 minutes. Because of the drawbacks, we are going for a automatic switching system. Okay. So in our syllabus, we'll discuss electromechanical crossbar as well as type of switching systems. But to explain the crossbar, you should know some basics of Strouger switching system. Okay. Now we'll see one by one. So in the previous case, we have an operator available to establish a connection between calling and call subscriber. In case of automatic switching systems, there is no human operator. With the help of electronic switch or electromechanical switch, we are going to establish a connection. So all we know that, so this, for this system, no numbering is required. No numbering scheme is required. Whereas for automatic, a proper numbering system is required to identify the subscriber in the network. Okay. So during the construction of this automatic switching system, the dialing numbering system came into the existence. Okay. So coming to the electromechanical, first one is Strouger. In Strouger's system, we use some mechanical parts, electromechanical parts, to establish a connection between calling and call subscriber. Okay. But the moving parts are more in case of Strouger. So to overcome this problem, they invented crossbar. So in crossbar, the moving parts are very less compared to the Strouger. Therefore, the call processing time is fast in case of crossbar when compared to the Strouger. Okay. But even it is having problem because as it contains electromechanical parts, okay, frequency maintenance is required. Because of years and years, it may get damaged. Okay. So to overcome this problem, we'll go for electronic switching systems. We know that electronic devices are very robust. Okay, without any fault, it can operate for millions of times. That's the advantage of using electronic switching systems. So in this, we have again two types, space division switching and time division switching. So before discussing this, we have one more concept called as stored program control concept. What is the meaning of stored program control concept? Means here we'll write some instructions and store in some memory of a computer. By executing those instructions, we are going to establish a connection between calling and called subscriber. So in case of electronic system or electromechanical, two things are important. One is called as signaling, and second one is called as controlling. What is signaling? For example, I want to make a call to some X person. he has to receive some ringtone. Then only we can observe that, okay, I'm getting some call. That is called as signaling. What is controlling? To establish a connection between calling and call subscriber, we have to operate n number of switching exchanges. That is called as controlling. So these two topics are very, very important, signaling and controlling. So with the help of a program stored in a memory, we are going to do signaling as well as controlling. That is called as stored program control concept. These electronic switching systems uses stored program control for signaling as well as for controlling. Now, what is space division and what is time division? So, as an engineer, our objective is to improve the system performance in terms of cost, in terms of efficiency, right? So, here, in case of space division, for example, A is one subscriber and B is another subscriber. Okay, my objective is to establish a connection between A and B. In case of space division switching system, we are going to allocate a dedicated switching path. This is one more technical term, switching path. What is switching path? It is the path between calling and call subscriber. Switching path, it may come across, for example, this is a subscriber in one exchange, this is an exchange, and this is another exchange, and this is the B subscriber. So to establish a connection between A and B, we have to create a path from A to exchange this one, from this exchange to this exchange, and from exchange to the subscriber B. This entire path is called as switching path. Okay. So in case of space division switching system, a dedicated path is given to the calling and call subscriber until the call is terminated. That is called as space division switching. Okay. Now, what is time division switching? So in the previous case, until unless A or B is terminating the call, this path is not used by another person. Of time division switching, the same path is used to establish a connection between more number of subscribers. For example, here some 10 subscribers are there, here some 10 subscribers are there. Okay, here I am using time division. That means I am going to divide the time into number of slots. Okay, for first 2 seconds, A in first exchange can able to call with B in second exchange. For next 2 seconds, C in first exchange can make a call to D in second exchange. Like that, the same switching path is used for communicating n number of subscribers. Clear? Because of this, we are effectively utilizing the switching paths. That means with the less number of switching paths, we can able to establish more number of calls. So compared to space division, time division is more efficient because we are using less number of resources or less number of switching paths to establish connection for a more number of subscribers. Now, in time division, again, 2 types are there, digital and analog. What is the meaning of analog time division and what is the meaning of digital time division? So, if I am without, we know that our signal is analog signal, right? Voice. Voice is analog signal. And data is digital, right? Voice is analog and data is digital. On the same switching network, I can able to transmit data and voice, right? In that scenario, if this switching path is used to transmit analog signals. It is called as analog timed switching. If I am using this timed switching for transmitting digital, it is called as digital time division switching. So you can also say this comes under store and forward concept. It uses store and forward concept. That means it contains some memory. Whatever the data will send, it stores some location. During its time interval, it will be transmitted. That is called as store and forward concept. This is digital time switching uses store and forward concept for transmitting your voice as well as data. So this is about classification of switching systems. Now in this class we'll see the manual switching system and its operation. So this is the manual switching system. Okay, so this is nothing but your exchange. Okay, so this is subscriber A, this is subscriber A, and this is subscriber B. Our objective is to establish a connection between A and B with the help of this manual exchange. So this exchange contains mainly a jacks as well as plugs. Along with that, we have an operator here. Okay. So whenever A wants to make a call, what he has to do? He has to hook off his telephone set. And one more technology here, hook off. Another one is hook on. What is meaning of hook off? Picking up the telephone receiver is called as hook off, and placing the telephone receiver is called as hook on. Okay, so whenever this person hook off his telephone set, from this telephone set it is going to send one electrical pulse to the exchange, where it is going to glow an LED. Okay, that indicates what? Then operator has to claim to know that, okay, someone is want to make a call. Then she is going to pick up his handset. Now she is going to connect this jack to this place so that she can able to listen whatever the A is speaking. So in case of manual system, there is no numbering system is there, right? Here the operator is going to identify the subscriber by his name and area. So they will have a logbook. In that logbook, they will have the addresses of the persons. Okay, whenever he explains the address, then she is going to generate a ringing bell. So this is for ringing. This is called as ringing bell, because he has to know, that is, he is getting some call. This process is called as signaling, right? This process is called as signaling. To understand or to make B to understand that he is getting a call, this operator is going to send one ringing bell. Okay, then this person is going to hook off his telephone set. Then the operator is going to explain, so and so person is want to make a call to you. Therefore, if you observe here, then with the help of a jumper, and one more thing, this is for B, they are going to connect to another jack. With the help of a jumper, they are going to connect these two subscribers. Therefore, now a path is available between A to the B. Okay, from here. This process is called as manual switching. And here, they are going to establish a switching path between A to the B with the help of these plugs and cables. Okay. Now A can able to talk with B. Clear? So whenever someone is hook on his telephone set, that means place the receiver on the telephone, then what happens? Here the LED will be disabled. That indicates what? They are want to terminate the call. Okay, therefore, she is going to remove this jack so that the connection between A and B will be terminated. So, what are the drawbacks in this method? The drawback is the time taken to establish the connection between calling and call subscriber is more. Why? Because this A has to intimate to the operator first. Then operator has to intimate to the B subscriber. Later, with the help of these jacks and jumpers, she has to establish a connection between A and B. So, perform the entire operation, it takes a lot of time. That is the one drawback. That is, call processing time is more in case of manual switching system. That is the one drawback. Coming to the second drawback, there is no privacy here. That means, whenever A and B are communicating, there is a chance that the operator can able to hear the communication between A and B. That is the second drawback in this manual switching system. And third one is, because of the negligence of the operator, some of the here the light is glowing, but the operator may not observe that lighting. Then what happens? Even though the switching paths are available, but A call is not successful. A call is not successful. Therefore, it is a drawback of the operator. These are the following drawbacks of this manual switching system. So, these drawbacks are overcome with the help of automatic switching system. So, that concept will be discussed in next class. Thank you.